According to research firm Market and Markets, the anti-drone market is growing at a compound annual growth rate of 24% and will be worth $1.14 billion by the year 2022. On Tuesday, France announced extra no-fly zones and detect and destroy systems for the Euro 2016 football tournament. Speaking to the Associated Press, Euro 2016 security chief Zayed Khoury said, "No-fly zones will be declared over all 10 stadiums as well as training grounds for the 24 teams. We've noted the general proliferation of drone usage in society. So no-fly zones will be defined over every training ground and every stadium, and in most stadiums for most matches, anti-drone measures, which are quite innovative and will be deployed working with the state, which will interfere with the drones and take control of them if they are spotted. Perfect timing then for Dedrone, who've received $10 million of Series A funding." Dedrone joint founder and CEO Jörg Lamprecht had this to say: "Any institution with an elevated need for security must now protect its airspace against intrusion from drones, and Dedrone passes that control back to our customers. This funding allows us to strengthen our leadership in this emerging market. With Menlo, we have a partner who can support us not only financially, but also with deep domain expertise in technology and security. Like others, the Dedrone system uses RF, or the radio, to detect the RPA C2 link. It hears it coming, listening out for its control radio and video feed. It then tracks it via signal strength and direction. Other systems are then able to disrupt or shoot down the drone using high-powered RF. So some detect and some destroy. It does leave one issue though. Who sent the thing? Well, also hitting my inbox yesterday, news of Canadian company Arion Labs, who are collaborating with LightEye and their AUDS system, AUD system. Arion Labs Skyranger, that's a quadcopter, will be integrated into the AUDs and go out and look for the operators of the RPA. Thomas Scott, president of LightEye, said, "Other UAS countermeasure platforms only deal with unfriendly UAS, but don't account for the operator of that UAS or other unfriendly personnel that may be present. Since AUDS is simultaneous ground and air surveillance, by deploying the Skyranger within the AUDS platform, AUDS is able to identify the operator of the unfriendly UAS and direct other ground-based or aerial assets to address the threat. When three stories about a particular technology all appear in my inbox within an hour of each other, do you think it makes it a trending topic?"